This instrument is so powerful that I would even call it a weapon of mass destruction, as it has allowed me to create a lot of videos with millions of views and memes with relative ease and speed. And I'm talking about Facefusion, an open source tool that enables you to easily create deepfakes, lip syncs, and colorized videos and images. In this video, we will cover everything you need to know about how to use this tool on your local machine, Windows and macOS, or in a cloud for absolutely free with cloud GPU. So let's start with local installation. Go through Facefusion repository on a GitHub. Then here you should find the link for manual how to install Facefusion to different environments, to different platforms like Linux, macOS and Windows. First of all, it's quite tricky and needs some kind of qualification because there is some terminal stuff, but here is also easy way to install. First one is, if you are on Windows, try to use Windows installer. This is a paid feature, but this is a really nice way to support developers of Facefusion. But we also have another way, much more easier. This is pinocchio.computer. Go to Pinocchio, and here some kind of Swiss Army knife for AI application. Just download application by pressing this button here, depending on your platform, macOS or Linux or Windows. In my case, it's macOS, but there is no practically any difference. In case of macOS installation, a bit tricky. After downloading your DMG installer, run this file and drag Pinocchio app to your application folder. After, you need to execute patch command. Press right button here and press open. This OK, just press open. After, you can run your application. Here you can configure all needed parameters. Let's try this one. Then to install Facefusion, just press here discover and find Facefusion. Then press download button, and after 20 or 30 minutes, installation will be completed. In case of Windows, the installation is similar. Just download your .exe file and then execute it. That's it. In case you don't have powerful GPU, you can use it Facefusion also in cloud. There are several options, like Kaggle, Colab, and Lightning.ai. I recommend to use Lightning.ai because it has much more powerful GPU NVIDIA Tesla L4, which is much more faster than regular Tesla T4. So let's try to use it Lightning.ai. Go to Home, press New Studio, choose Code, and press Start. All right, here you should add my Jupyter notebook file, which available by the link below under this video in a Patreon, which is free. After downloading this file, press this button here, upload files, and upload Facefusion base file. All right, there is two steps, installation and run Facefusion. Let's install all needed requirements by choosing this cell and pressing this button here, run this cell. It takes about 5 minutes to install all requirements. Alright, all needed requirements just has been installed, and then try to run Facefusion. Choose this cell and press run button. At this stage, we also downloading some models and needed requirements for Facefusion. It takes about 2 minutes. Alright, we just run our Facefusion application. It's available only by local URL. We need to run it using gradual share flag, and we can do it by following to Facefusion. But before, stop this cell by choosing this cell and pressing this button here, stop this cell, interrupt the kernel. Go to Facefusion, Facefusion once again, UIs, layouts, and choose default. Here, UI.qui.launch, we should add our parameter share equal true. All right, let's try run it once again. Great, we've got our public URL and we are in a Facefusion application. But very important to note that we are running Facefusion using CPU, and this is extremely slow. Let's choose GPU mode here and choose L4 GPU. Press confirm, and we need to wait about 10 minutes. All right, we just switched to NVIDIA Tesla T4 L4 and open this script here. Once again, run this cell by choosing this cell and pressing run button here. Important to note that we don't need to install all requirements once again, just only once. And here we've got our public URL.
Let's start with basic face swap for images. Choose your source image here. Let it be this lady. And for target, let's choose this one. Here are several options for frame processors. Face swapper, face debugger, face enhancer, colorizer, and frame enhancer lip syncer. So in case of face swapping of images, we should choose obviously face swapper and face enhancer in order to make quality of face a bit better. Here in our face enhancer model, we can see several options. Let's choose the standard one, GFPGGAN 1.4. But you can experiment with different enhance models. Then, important moment, we should choose a face enhancer blend. To my mind, the best options is about 70. This make our face looks a bit more natural. Here also face swapper models, and to my mind, the standard one is the best one. I forgot to mention that we should choose a proper execution provider. In case of cloud GPU, we should choose CUDA in order to use our GPU. For macOS, we should choose Core ML, which drastically improve the speed of processing. Alright, here we have options for face selection mode. To my mind, reference is a good one. In this case, it's quite obvious because we have under one face. Let's choose this one. Also, reference face distance. It's important for specifying and determine the face. There is also a parameter for mask blur. Once again, to my mind, this is the best one, 0.3. Also, face mask padding, top, right, left, and bottom. You can experiment with this freely to choose the best one for your specific user case. We just choose all needed parameters, and to finish our processing, just press start button here. Alright, we've got a result, and it looks quite solid and looks quite natural. So, the next one is colorization. For this one, let's take, for example, this video of Chaplin. In a frame processor, we should choose proper processor for our tasks. In this case, obviously, we should choose frame colorizer. There are several options for colorizer model. You can easily experiment with this and also frame colorizer blend. Let's turn it down a little bit, let it be 85, and press start button to process our video. Alright, after 20 seconds we processed our video. Here you can see the final results. It takes about 20 seconds to process, and as you can see, it looks very nice. Obviously, there is some artifacts in terms of flickering, but you can cope this effect or minimize this effect by experimenting with different parameters. Let's try to face swap video. Choose your source image and your target video. So, in this case, we also should choose proper frame processors. Quite obvious that we should choose face swapper, and as a previous one, for images, we should choose face enhancer. Here we have several options for face enhancer model, and to my mind, once again, the default one is the best one. So, let's try to choose this one, 1.3 GFPGGAN, and face enhancer blend. Let's turn it down a little bit, 270. Don't forget to choose a proper execution provider to CUDA from CPU. And now we need to choose proper reference face. Let's try Homelander. Alright, and by the way, this is a very good video fragment because it allows us to understand how well face user handle with different head angles. Here we should choose face mask types. In majority of cases, box is good mask for basic usage, but if you have a lot of movement in a video, in your footage, the best one will be occlusion mask. Here is a lot of options for face mask blur and face mask padding top. But in this case, everything already looks nice. So let's try just process this video. The processing has been finished in 40 seconds, and let's try to see what we've got.
All right. So what happens if, I don't know, I do this?
The result looks not so bad, but of course there is some artifacts which you can actually minimize with different techniques. For example, in a DaVinci Resolve or any editing software, you can try to use interpolation, frame interpolation, different filters, mask tracking, and a lot of different instruments. Also important to find the best parameters for your specific footage in a Facefusion, but to my mind, the default ones is working the best way for majority of videos. And the final, how to use lip sync. Let's try to choose another footage for target. And for source, we should choose also audio. Important to note that if you wanna face swap and make lip sync simultaneously, for this case, you should choose image and source audio simultaneously. Of course, in this case, we don't need face swapper, but only lip syncer should be the first one. And then we should process the video by face enhancer processor. Unfortunately, the base model lip syncer has extremely low resolution, and we are forced to use face enhancer to improve the quality of lip syncer. This is a very serious restriction, which is really hard to cope, and we still has noticeable artifacts even after applying of face enhancer. But the developers of Facefusion trying to crowdfund some money for training a high resolution WAF to lip model. If you have ability to help them, you're welcome to do so. So nice, we should just press start button in order to run lip sync process. Well, the video has been processed in 30 seconds for me, and here we can see the final result.
I am not in danger, Skylar. I am the danger. A guy opens his door and gets shot and you think that of me? No, I am the one who knocks.
As I said before, there is obviously some artifacts, but it's still not so bad. That's all for now. Thanks for watching, and I hope that you like this video. Bye bye.